Hello and welcome. In today's video, I'm going to introduce you to Infor's newest technology solution, the Infor Application Designer, which is Infor's no-code or low-code solution to building applications in the cloud. So what exactly is Infor App Designer? IAD is Infor's new application development framework for Infor OS Portal. It takes advantage of the best concepts that we have had in our previous frameworks, like Mongoose and App Builder, and brings it up to present day. This utilizes a no-code, low-code approach for creating and deploying widgets in Portal workspaces. IAD is a cloud-only toolkit for multi-tenant Cloud Suite customers for maximum benefit and stability. It also utilizes a tight integration with the Infor Design System standards, so all of the componentry that is utilized comes directly from the Infor Design System libraries. It runs seamlessly with the Infor OS Portal because it utilizes Portal as the runtime presentation layer exclusively. Lastly, IAD takes advantage of Infor OS even further by utilizing the Infor API gateway for all of the data sources. In IAD, users can create beautiful widgets that can be used in an Infor OS Portal workspace. These widgets can be made contextual and can relate information to one another. Currently, the in-context is limited to workspaces, but in the future, IAD will allow for in-context to ERP systems as well. Some of the key features of Infor App Designer include translations, built-in translation capabilities for multilingual application development. You can build in one language and display in another. APIs. IAD utilizes the API gateway for data source definitions. Those definitions are defined inside IAD, yet still utilize the Swagger documentation from Ion API. Template-based design. In the current version, there are 5 different templates the user can choose from. Those include a simple list, chart control, forms control, record page control, and a grid control. In future versions, more templates are planned on being added to the template library. No-code or low-code wizards. This is a wizard construction-based tool that will step you through building out a widget with no coding necessary. In the future, this wizard will step you through designing a full application. Version control. Versioning control is provided by the designer. Widgets can be drafted, published, and then deployed into a widget catalog. This can allow for 3 versions of a widget inside of a particular design lifecycle. Widget catalog. Widgets can be deployed into a widget catalog for users to reuse. The version that is deployed can be controlled from the Publish Widgets section, where the user can specify which version they want to deploy in the catalog. In context, like we discussed earlier, widgets can communicate with one another using in-context messaging. And lastly, built-in permissions. Because IAD resides within Portal, it employs IFS, SSO, and user roles for managing and accessing information. So let's look at a demo of Infor App Designer. IAD can be accessed directly from within the Infor OS Portal. Here's the translations where we can define the translations that we want to appear on our application. Here you can create and maintain those translation strings that you can select when developing widgets. Next, we have data services, also known as data sources. These are all the defined data services that have been built on top of the API gateway. These are APIs provided by the ERPs or other APIs that are available through the API gateway. In the next video, I'll demonstrate how to set up a data service in IAD. So make sure you're subscribed to the Infor Technology YouTube channel so you don't miss it. Next, we can go into our pages where you can see drafts, published, and archive pages. But in the future, these will be expanded into full application pages. In this next part, I'm going to walk you through the designer and demonstrate just how easy it is to build a widget with an Infor App Designer. From the draft section, select New Page and select from one of the predefined templates provided. The second step is to specify the page attributes and what components you want to display. The third step is where you can specify your page properties, such as name and description. Step 4 is to select the data service that you want your widget to connect to. Step 5 is to define any translatable strings that you want to use. Once you've finished the wizard, you can now bind your components to the data service we selected in step 4. Click on an element on the left and select what data properties you want it to bind it to. Once you have all of your elements bound, click Finish to complete the draft of your widget. To publish the widget, click on the ellipsis and select Publish. Now, if you move to the Publish Pages section, you can see our new widget. Notice the green checkmark in the top left of the other widgets. This means that that widget has been deployed to the widget catalog. To deploy a widget, select the ellipsis and select Deploy. Now, our widget is available to add to a workspace. If I open up a workspace and click Add, you can see my new widget is now in the widget catalog. These templates also have built-in functionality, such as search and in-context messaging. I can do wildcard searches on my data and can also switch between records to see record-specific data. This concludes today's video. For more upcoming content, make sure to like and subscribe to the Infor Technology YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.